Jack Frost, what statin are you taking? And dosage, thanks. Great question about the statins. I rarely use high dose statins because I don't use statins for decreasing LDL, usually. Half the people that have a heart attack or stroke have normal LDL, so that's plenty of evidence for me that LDL is rarely the issue. But statins have what we call a pleiotropic effect. Pleo meaning other, trophic meaning to go to. So pleiotropic effect means that, you know, while most docs are looking at dropping that LDL, I'm looking at something entirely different. I'm looking at decreasing cardiovascular inflammation. And it has been demonstrated that, and there's plenty of science out there showing that it does. So what I was taking for the longest time, well, first of all, I delayed taking statin for a couple of years, even though I was developing hypertension and some of those problems. I thought I had my lifestyle totally tuned in. There were actually some things that I could do. There are always things that you can do. You can always improve. For example, right now, I'm back up to about high 150s, and I'm going to be looking at losing another 5 pounds again. I've been using that meal replacement just to get an understanding of how it works. Bottom line, I've used Crestor 5 milligrams. That's what I tend to use. Now, Crestor has been, it's got a half-life of 17 hours. So you can often use Crestor or rosuvastatin, generic name. You can often use that every other day, 3 times a week, or even there's been research demonstrating you can get an improvement in cardiovascular inflammation from rosuvastatin once a week. Now, I don't routinely go there, but again, work very hard to accommodate the desires, concerns that a patient has. And I don't have a top-down type of approach. I don't tell a patient, look, this is what you're going to take. I don't spend 7 minutes with a patient, write them a script and walk out the door. We talk a lot further. We have typical discussions will be between 1.5 and 2 hours, a half an hour. Our goal is to get them to half an hour, but we've never been able to do that. They're usually 1 hour to 2 hours. Jack, you've asked me what time it is. I've told you how to make a watch. Let me go back and repeat. I was on statin 5 milligrams a day, rosuvastatin 5 milligrams a day. About 2 months ago, I switched to pitavastatin. What is pitavastatin? It's the generic version of Livalo or pitavastatin, 1 milligram once a day.
There's nothing like a community. We saw that in the Louisville event. People got together and started talking about how they've had challenges and successes in preventing their own heart attack, stroke, or chronic disease. It became very clear that you don't have to be a doc with a full-time 30-year career in preventive medicine to understand this and successfully prevent heart attack, stroke, the number one killer and disablers of people. You don't have to be a physician to prevent eye disease, kidney disease. All you have to do is think, listen, and become part of the community. Now, how do you do that? Go to the membership login on our webpage, and as you can see, you can get right in. You have to sign up if you haven't signed up already, and I've already signed up. I've already gone in. It's very simple, very easy to understand. In order to help encourage this, after the success and the positive emotion, the positive impact that we're seeing with these events, we're saying, look, we need to offer more of these services for free in order to help grow this community. So you'll see us starting to do drawings for the webinar event, the courses. We've got a book coming out in about a month. We'll be offering that. Even full-blown evaluations, providing those for free for folks that, again, help us grow the community. So if you'd like to find out what the most recent rules are for the most recent drawing, just come to the membership page. Thank you for your interest.